Lake Michigan can be a bellwether for what's happening in our region. It's one of the largest lakes in the world, over 70 miles wide, 300 miles long, and its deepest point dives down more than 900 feet. And it is a mighty force, a freshwater ocean. The lake is situated between Wisconsin and Michigan, touching Indiana and helping to link our shores to the Atlantic Ocean. Meteorologist Molly Bernard investigates what we're learning from the changes we see on the Great Lakes. Molly?
Mark, I'm here at beautiful Atwater Beach in Shorewood, and it's one of the places that residents come year-round to get a front-row seat to this great lake. Lake Michigan has more than 1,000 cubic miles of fresh water, but its levels are always changing. But Wisconsin scientists tell me climate change is impacting this inland ocean.
Lake Michigan draws people outside.
So I live right on the east side by the lake, so it's easier. I just love being by the lake.
But Suganda Matharu tells me she's noticed less beach space the last few years. Susan Bednar says she's seen the same in her friend's backyard.
We used to have enough sand beach that we'd play baseball. The neighborhood kids would come and play baseball there, and there's no beach left.
Less beach caused by higher lake levels could be a product of climate change.
Tell me about the Lake Michigan system and what controls the water levels on the lake.
Yeah, it's actually pretty complicated, but you can simplify it by thinking about it's very similar to a bank account. So there's income and expenses.
Paul Rober is a distinguished professor of atmospheric science at UW-Milwaukee. He says the lake's income is precipitation and the expenses are evaporation. Both are impacted by our changing climate.
Ice cover in the winter has a really important control on evaporation the following year. If you have a relatively ice-free condition, which we've had a lot of in recent years, you'll get more evaporation that will drive the lake level down.
Less ice causes the lake temperature to climb faster.
Historically, we used to get maximum temperatures in the summer near shore, typically in the upper 60s. And like I said, now in the middle of the lake, you can get temperatures as high as 80 or 81 degrees Fahrenheit.
When air temperature is colder than the lake, water is evaporating. You could see it in real time when Arctic sea smoke formed this winter. But warmer water means evaporation is more likely year-round.
Now, if you also get more precipitation, which we also get as a result of climate change on average, it won't necessarily drive it down.
To better understand the balance, Rober created a climate model for Lake Michigan. He found the change will be in the lake's extremes.
So for example, the average lake level might not change at all, but the highest levels could be much higher than they have been historically.
And the lowest levels even lower.
It fell to extremely low values for about a decade, where it was actually bouncing around near record low levels and finally did hit the record in 2013. And then started going up again.
From the water line here, you can see how much Lake Michigan has dropped since its record highs in 2020. That fast change can't be linked to climate change yet, but there may be a connection.
You can think of it as loading the dice. So if the probability of getting these sort of changes has increased because of the ice cover changes, so it's not that this particular one is necessarily forced by climate change, just the likelihood of seeing things like that is because of climate change.
But the increased likelihood of seeing swings and record levels spells trouble. High levels increase the risk of erosion. Low levels have a huge impact on shipping and boating.
If the lake levels go down and they just stayed down there, it wouldn't be great, but we can do things about that because we can dredge channels and move marinas and things like that. But if it goes down and then a couple years later it's going way up, you can't do that very effectively.
We love our life on the lake. We use these waters for both play and work. But these extremes, both high and low, will make a lot of activities more difficult. And that leaves everyone along Lake Michigan left to find a solution to a very complicated problem. Mark?
Thanks, Molly. As meteorologists, we love the challenge that Lake Michigan brings for all of us forecasting the weather around here.